fucking awful. This is gonna be the worst thing that people are gonna listen to in a long ass time.
I haven't cried from cringe in a long time.
So anyway, I'm Skiff, and we got
Zach,
Comanche,
Tyler.
And Tyler, okay.
Yeah.
So yeah, welcome to the Level Boys Podcast. This is gonna be real degenerate shit for like the next hour, maybe. It depends on when we want to stop hating ourselves. So anyway, what do we got for today?
We can start with the Realbotix thing, I guess, yeah. Since that's pretty fresh.
So what is the Realbotix? Since you want to bring this up.
Well, I was just browsing the Facebook, saw a robot, and they have different models and stuff. One that I saw of note was Asa Akira, a better known Asian...
The only Asian with boobs.
...porn star. And so it's supposed to be a conversational partner, but it also obviously has sexual capabilities. And it's got hundreds of different voices that you can program into it. And it's supposed to learn things about you.
So do they build like robots for anything, or just like they only have so specific models?
Well, I think since it's so fresh, we're still really focused on that, like jacking ourselves off with that kind of stuff.
I think the best or worst case scenario, depending on how you look at this, is like a Tess Holliday model, right? But with like Gilbert Gottfried's voice.
I'd buy it.
So just imagine like... You're just like, it's just this fat, awful person. And like, you go to have like sex with it, it just starts screaming, "Oh, baby!"
And like, people are recording it and stuff and posting it in shit groups.
Oh, yeah.
And stuff, trying to see how, I don't know, how if they can outdo one another. Because that's where I see that going. Like, how long can you subject yourself to Gilbert Gottfried while fucking a robot?
Especially like a Tess Holliday version.
Jesus Christ. Fun with family functions, yeah.
But it remembers stuff about you too, so like, I wonder if it's like kind of like a parrot, how like you'll say shit to a parrot or around a parrot and you won't think about it, and then somebody will come around and he'll start screaming out some real crazy shit. Like, I wonder if the robot will just pop out and say something crazy.
Like a Freddy Fazbear. You gotta watch where it is before he kills you.
It says it remembers the little details about you, and I think that's a slight... What does that mean, the little details? It kind of pisses me off a little bit.
Maybe I like rim jobs. Yeah.
Is it my pee-pee?
It remembers your sexual preferences and how you grind your hips. It's like, I've seen that before.
What if you take her like the bruiser to your parents?
It just starts crying.
Asking for help.
Is your waifu pillow just stares at you from the corner?
I don't know. I've seen Ex Machina. I don't know if you guys have. That movie fucked me up with robots, though.
People pulling robots? Or?
Nah, well, yeah. I mean, that's in there. But more so, like, the whole plot is, like, this guy gets flown out by the creator of this robot and basically wants to see if this dude can give this robot a test. And I forget what the test is called, but it's to say if it could pass as a human. And so he ends up falling in love with this robot. And it's an older movie, so I'm not going to... I mean, spoiler alert, I guess, but like, whatever. At the end of it, almost everyone dies, except for this last robot and the guy that fell in love with her. She locks him in a room and leaves. And he can't get out.
What the fuck?
So she spends like this whole hour-long like part of this movie just convincing him that he needs to help her get out and like get out from under thumb of this, you know, I guess tyrannical like owner, ruler, creator of her. And yeah, she fucks him over and leaves. And then she goes to the city and that's it. And like, that's the whole movie. So I'm assuming like dude dies, you know, of starvation or something in this like vault underground. While she goes and just does whatever the fuck she does. So I'm wondering if, like, we're eventually going to get to that Terminator level.
I mean, you get, like, Stephen Hawking and Elon Musk, like, constantly warn about, like, the dangers of AI and shit. So, like,
yeah.
It's only a matter of time till we get there. So, like,
it's coming.
Yeah. Well, I mean, the last robot movie I remember watching is the Fresh Prince of iRobot. So, Jesus. That's about where I go in that part.
I think it's amazing that the amount of resources put into fucking things.
Right, that's what I'm saying.
Like, we could be doing like, so many better things. Like, we could be preventing people getting killed in our military, or, well, I mean, that's the only thing I can think of. But
I mean, let's see. Let's establish a timeline. Like, let's say that for sure, sometime down the line, robots are gonna kill us.
Yeah.
How long and from here to then do you think is gonna be spent purely on like fucking robots? Like, we're saying like a solid 30-70% of the time.
Well, what if we like
personally or? That's an investment level sex toy. That's something that, I mean, I'm gonna fuck it.
Okay.
But I want to make sure.
Like,
but I'm gonna take care of it. It's gonna sit in a pristine box in the closet, and you know,
like the fine china, yeah.
Yeah, you know, when the friends come over, kind of thing.
Well, what if we just like, I mean, sex robots, but they're all sex robots. But we just create like a bunch of like dom robots.
Robots that beat the shit out of you?
Or no, I was looking for that. I'm looking for submissive.
Okay, I was going to say.
So we create a bunch of submissive robots.
That's the Terminator shit we're trying to get away
like,
from.
Like, no, we need submissive robots so like we can counterfight the robot army like when they rise up.
Ooh, how long do you think until we have robot rights included in like they deserve
years.
To be able to marry each other
45
and shit
years.
Like that? They deserve autonomy, all that? How
here's
long?
Here's an interesting
45 thought. Years.
Now these already exist, but there are like lowly sex dolls, so like kid sex dolls out mm-hmm. there. How long do you think that people will defend like pedophilia and things like that if those become more intricate? If we have like
that's
realistic,
I mean, if someone makes a kid robot, like you're weird, but I mean, at least you're not
right.
fucking real kids,
right? Because pedophilia,
but you are supplementing that idea.
Yeah, no, I get that, but like, if you look at it, like,
you don't
some people can't
be
help
encouraging
it.
Oh, but
yeah, no, absolutely, but you know how some people just can't help it.
Yeah,
that's
too?
The gateway to
it's
the
a
robot
disorder.
Race. It is. You'd be like, don't fuck child robots. And then, and you know,
how
one
long
thing,
has this been going on?
One thing leads to another, leads to another.
We're talking about child robots.
And down the line, you know, eventually we're going to have to draw a line. And
but what if the child robots programmed to sex?
That would be awkward as shit. Oh my god.
Future.
You know, kids could open the door and she's like, hey, who the hell are you? Suck?
Man, I really wasn't.
Oh, they're panhandling now.
I really wasn't, you know, hoping that we'd have, like, FBI cease and desist on the very first, like, real episode of this shit.
Hello, NSA.
Oh, Jesus.
People are listening.
Oh, my God.
I'm sorry.
All right, so anyways, say they develop this technology for, like, 10 more years, and you save up a good chunk of money for it. What is a profound quality you would look for in your own purchase?
In a robot?
Yeah. Like, what would make it stand out from, like, the 14 models you can find at any store, say, 10 years from now?
If it was Kate, but just, like, wouldn't argue with me.
I would like a cooling fan. I would like a fan that blows in my face.
When she's just straddling you or whatever, her head,
right.
It's just a fucking box fan. Cooling off your body.
I like that though, because that's like
that's
that.
The worst thing about sex is that you get sweaty, right? Because sex is a great thing, but then you have to take a shower.
Is this what it's like to experience five guns?
I'm over here racking my brain, like, oh, transform into a motorcycle. And like, I would just really like something that cools me off after sex, you know?
During sex,
it's like
just
going.
It's
a Harley Davidson model.
I mean, branding is a good idea, yeah. Like,
I don't know.
You gotta fund it somehow.
I feel like I would want something to just, like, be my own personal secretary. To, like, write my shit down
yeah.
so I don't have to. That's really all I would look for.
So you want to be Bill Clinton and you want to have a Monica Lewinsky?
I'm not bringing sex into this at all.
So you want a sex robot, you can't sex.
You want a secretary.
He didn't say sex robot. He said what
no,
kind
he said
of
sex
robot?
Robot.
I mean, I feel like it was implied, but I'll give it to you.
Okay.
I didn't. Fine. I didn't.
I mean, you
just
still can take
specify.
A secretary sex robot. Like, no one's going to argue it.
I mean, yeah. It's kind of all purpose then.
No, because then we got to worry about the female uprising. They're not getting
well,
enough.
They're going to have their own sex dolls.
No, they hate men anyway, so this is just our own comment.
No, I'm just going to stick with my vanilla.
Transform
missionary secretary sex robot.
You're a Harley Davidson sex doll.
No.
Like a transformer.
What does the Bible say about robots, though?
Loopholes.
We need another update.
I mean, you could technically have gay sex with a gay sex robot, and it wouldn't be like a thing in the Bible.
A
that's
gay
like
sex
dad.
Robot?
It's not another man. It's man shall not lie with robot.
Beep boop. Loopholes, man. It's all about the loopholes.
It's all about the poop holes, let's be honest.
Okay. Are we done?
All right. Well, this was a fun topic.
Yeah.
You know what the worst part about this is? We're only like 11 minutes in.
Jesus Christ.
All right. I've got one.
Oh.
So, completely changing tracks here off of the sexual robotics.
I'm totally looping this around.
So, basically, I'm asking, what do you guys, like, look for in video games, right? Because I've noticed that there's, like, a vast difference between, like, obviously my taste and other people's taste. So people are like, oh, have you ever played, you know, Zelda, blah, 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 or have you played Sonic? And over I say no. I played one Zelda game my whole life. I played Sonic for, like, 1 to 2 levels, so I get the gist of it. But, like, some people are like, oh, how have you not played that? I've played every single one in the Sonic series, and it's amazing, and blah, blah, blah. So I'm, like, I'm curious as to what you guys look for in video games, because I feel like, me personally, with like me being like FPS and RPG kind of person, like I know that I look for things. Even like I didn't like The Witcher, even though that's like a prime time RPG that people really like.
My first concern is like, who the hell told you that this whole Sonic series is great? Because Sonic 06 is a pile of shit.
But see, I don't even know that. Like, I don't have any information to base. Like, I would never know that.
Yeah, I get that. But man, like, if anybody ever told me that the whole Sonic series was good, I'd be really fucking upset, because like, Sonic the Hedgehog 4, like, episode 1, straight ass.
See, like, I'm fucking lost. I have no idea. Dude, that's what I'm asking, because, like, I'm curious what you guys have.
I don't know, man. I don't really care, like, what kind of view. Like, I'll play literally every kind of video game. It's just a matter of, like, is the gameplay good? Because I can deal with, like, a shit story, but if the gameplay is super fucking fun, like, that's what gets me. Like, arcade-type games, I'll play for hours. Mm-hmm. That shit gets me every fucking time.
I am the opposite. I have to have, I'm story driven, and it has to have customization. It has to be different every time I play it.
I get you. See, I can deal with it. I can, like, if there's a great story, that also gives me, like, incentive to play. But, like, if it's, like, a great story, but, like, super limited controls, I'll be, like, super disappointed. Like, Journey is about the furthest I'll go down that with a minimum controls, but, like, great story. I mean, it's not, like, a real big story. It's really subtle throughout the whole thing, but like, you know, that's about as far as I'd go with that one.
Okay,
that's why it was so popular, is because of simplicity.
Yeah.
Plus the graphics. I gotta say, what I like in video games, going from like 10 years ago, being able to play, you know, come home from school, you play for like 10 hours to like 3 in the morning, you go to bed, you wake up,
right,
go to school, that type of deal. Now I'm growing older, full time job, wife, I don't have time to play as much as I used to. I'm gonna say gameplay is a big one. I like story and customization, but I gotta be able to pick it up, be super engaged, and play it for any length of time. Sometimes I only have like an hour. Sometimes I can binge like 6 hours, and I need something I can pick up and put down pretty quickly without.
Yeah, that makes sense. Especially when you're like, you start a family and shit like that.
Yeah, I don't want to be able to have like a game that's so detailed where I need to sit up and sit down and dedicate 4+ hours to like getting into it and then go from there. Because I mean, I just don't have that time. I haven't been playing games as much as
I still do
because
that.
Of that.
I still do that, even though I'm married. It's because
it's fine.
I'll beat Kate.
Jesus.
Spoiler alert.
Sooner replace you for a sex doll.
Fuck.
Is it too early for a loop around? Or?
I don't know. So the bad news is the sex doll that I was replaced with. And then they call me a better lover.
She's going to buy the sex doll for her.
A new cup term in there
told
somewhere.
Told you, man, we're going back to poop holes.
Yeah, fuck your own replacement robot. That'll show her.
Did the robot fuck your ass? Yeah, but like, I got Kate. I showed her who's boss. Yeah, but the robot fucked your ass. I didn't win here, huh?
Yeah.
What is it, gay though?
Win in Rome. Win at home. So, I want to know what your guys' like life goals are and how your parents have stopped you from achieving them.
Essence, you're pretty much out of this conversation, aren't you?
Am I?
I felt like your parents like always supported you and shit.
For the most part.
Uh-oh.
No, so right now I'm like actually actively pursuing my life goals. Like I'm actually going to this college, Berklee College of Music.
Edit that out.
Oh, Yeah, no. Plug in there. Berkeley sponsors.
Going to Berkeley.
Berkeley. Yeah. So when I first got the idea that I wanted to like do music, like in all actuality, I was probably a sophomore or a junior in high school, and I started looking up colleges and stuff, and like naturally the first place my mind went was California. And so there's an institute there called Musicians Institute where a bunch of bands that I know of have gone and like came out of successfully. Like there's a band called Scale the Summit that had
very beautiful.
Yeah, their bassist is now in The Contortionist. He's amazing. They all met at Musicians Institute, and Chris Letchford, still the guitarist of Scale the Summit, both fantastic players. And so I was like, dude, that's where I need to go. Like that just sounds perfect. It's in California, so it's got the big fish pond. You know, it's music related, blah, blah, blah. My parents were like, I don't think you're going to be able to do that. And I was like, whoa, hold on, what do you mean? And they were kind of right at one hand. Like, I kind of wish I hadn't listened a little bit, because I would have already been, like, further down instead of taking, like, a big military detour. But on the other hand, like, they were kind of right, too, because they were talking about how much more financially hard, like, how much of a bigger financial burden it would be to live in California on my own. While I don't know anybody there, also trying to fund like musician school and shit, which is more of a specialization and stuff. So, for the most part, like they kind of stopped me from pursuing one dream because it wasn't exactly the right way, but it ended up working out better because now I'm on a much better path for it. So, I wouldn't say that they stopped me from
GI Bill.
They didn't stop me in a negative connotation.
Yeah.
So, that's
like,
my goal.
I remember I was like 8 and I was like, just starting to play basketball and shit like that. I've been playing for a couple of years, but I was really big on it. And I'm like, I want to be in the NBA. And like verbatim, they're pretty much, that's not fucking happening.
Manlet.
Manlet. No, because like, what was it? Like, that was like the original thing. And then like, I remember having a separate conversation with my dad later on. He goes, if you want to do that, you got to practice like 10 hours a day. And like, you just don't have the dedication. Like, I was like, ugh. And at the time, I'm like, yeah, they're probably right. But then I look back on it, I'm like, man, they were right, but fuck them. That was real
shitty. Fuck you a little bit, but yeah, you're right. Thank
you. Yeah, no, you're definitely right. I mean, I'm good in my life now, so I'm not really upset about it. But like, yeah, there was definitely a couple times where I want to do this, and I'm like, no.
Space Jam a big inspiration.
Space Jam was like one of my favorite movies, right?
Yeah.
You know,
once. I was more partial to Basketball Jones. I had that soundtrack as a kid.
I mean,
I was an air.
You didn't want to stretch your arm 30 feet from the half court line.
I mean, who didn't? I have that soundtrack on cassette. Yeah.
Oh, I had it on CD.
Nothing
nice.
Wrong with that.
Good throwback. Speaking of, if we're gonna talk about genetic lottery here, the guy sitting directly across from me just refuses. He's so short that he refuses to believe that his roommate can be 6 feet tall.
No.
He will not fucking drop it.
No, okay. So listen. So basically, I'm pretty content with the fact that I'm 5'8", and I've always just told myself I'm 5'8" for like the past 10 years of my life because I don't know, I can't grow. So like, I'm probably like 5'9", 5'10" now. But
drink milk.
Like,
can't
it was
grow.
Seriously like it's like I'm only
horizontally.
No, listen. Yes. But, like, me and Essence have had this argument, and he's, like, telling himself he's 6 foot, and I'm like, you're only a couple inches.
Myself.
He's like, I'm 6 foot. I'm like, no, because you're only, like, a couple inches tall. I mean, there's no way I'm, like, 5'10", right? So, like, the other day, we actually have a mark over on our door over there, because we were finally deciding to settle it, and, like, we measured it out, and then, we set a mark, and then we only had a tape measure for about, like, 60 inches, so we have to like double measure. And what it turned
out,
we're
backwards rigging
this
shit.
We're sitting there, and it turns out he's 5'11 and a half.
So now, the first one was 5'11 and 3/4, then the second one was 5'11 and a half.
Yeah,
so there's like a 0.25.
No, that was a two person system, so 5'11 and a half is definitely more accurate.
I think if we actually had a full measuring thing, because on my driver's license, like most people have to put theirs in, right? They're like, how much do you weigh? How tall are you? I didn't get to do that. I had to, see, she knows. I had to actually stand up next to this big ass like poster, and they had to take like my measurement for me, and then they wrote it down on my paper, and it says 6 foot. So since that day, I'm fucking
shoes?
Stick to it. No, they made me take off my shoes and everything.
I'm sorry, man. I don't think you're 6 foot.
See,
as
that's what I'm saying.
I,
he has such an aggressive mentality towards a genetic lottery. He refuses to believe that me, his roommate, who I guess we have some sort of rivalry. Is that what it is?
Absolutely we do.
Okay, so it's based off of the rivalry that I won a better ticket in the genetic lottery.
Oh, I do not have anything in the genetic lottery at all. I'm not spiteful about it. It's just fun to know that you're 5'11 and a half. Because at first I was like, no, I need him to be 5'10 just to prove myself right. But the fact that he ends up being like a half inch short from 6 foot is just so much
better. I'm calling it faulty measuring.
But yeah, no, genetic lottery is definitely definitely a shit stick on my end. I'm like 5'8, maybe 5'9. Basic looking as fuck.
Yeah.
Like, I get
you're
mistaken.
Like character preset one.
Yeah.
I get mistaken for so many other people, like, all the fucking time. And if people just like, oh man, you look just like a friend of mine from blah blah blah. I'm like, that doesn't fucking mean anything to me. It's such a bad, like, fucking hand I've been dealt. I blame my dad because I look just like him.
I feel like you should grow a mustache or something. Something.
I agree with that.
Something to precede you besides just rumor.
No, because I've grown out my facial hair, like, when I'm on vacation and shit like that. And then, like, I'll shave it just to show the mustache. Mm-hmm. And it's not nice. It's not a good look for
me. If you don't spend a lot of time around schools, there's no reason why you shouldn't get a mustache. There's so many utilitarian
uses. Should we put it to a vote?
A mustache.
All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Oh, so I'm
okay.
I'm growing a mustache.
Well,
sorry,
I think that's how mustaches work, though. Like, it's inversely
work like this, right?
It's inversely proportionate. You know, like, if it looks terrible, that means it's a better mustache.
Yeah,
right.
Honestly,
exactly.
And if it's a great mustache, then I mean,
as long as it's not,
it's
patchy right in the center. You know,
I mean, think
if
of like,
you have the reverse, Michael Jordan.
Think of all great mustaches, though. Dr. Phil, any character from Tombstone, if you could pull them off, it's a bad mustache. Nobody can pull any of those off.
No, it's just, if anybody, like, if I actually started wearing a mustache, I'd have to deal with the initial, you look like a fucking child toucher or something like that.
My wife
and then, like, after a while, it's just
like, you have something you want to hide from them?
No, it's just, I just don't feel like dealing with those jokes, because, like, the people I work with, I'm always the guy giving the jokes, so, like, as soon as anybody finds any opportunity, no. As soon as anybody finds any opportunity to jump on me, how many people jump? Like, remember when I had
all the time.
Remember when I had the cyst on my tailbone?
Mm-hmm.
And like at first, the doctor was like, "Oh, it's an anal fissure."
Oh hell!
Like, and everyone
hell
is like,
yeah.
"Oh, Skip is fucked right now."
Oh my god, that was prime beef.
I can't wait till this
roast.
Guy walks in. Like,
hell
Skip,
yeah!
You're looking butthurt today.
Fucking got him.
That was like the worst fucking like. 2 weeks of my life.
Yeah, that was nothing but a big Skiff spit roast.
I mean,
that
it wasn't
was fucking awesome.
Like, are we talking like spit roast like cooking food or spit roast like?
I mean, all of
like
the
August
above.
Ames before she
Jesus
died.
Jesus Christ!
As long as the porn stars aren't gay, I guess she's totally down to be spit roasted.
I still feel so bad for that.
Oh, that's definitely a shitty situation.
There's a doll for that.
August Ames will live on in my heart through my $3.99 sex doll.
Jesus.
Speaking of sex dolls, I want to talk about dreidels for a second, if we could. Easy transition. It's just like a PowerPoint transition. Why did Beyblade not reach out to the Jewish community more? They wasted so much opportunity.
I'm just imagining like the Beyblades and you collect the parts and you only get the little beast token in the middle and shit.
Oh,
like, what is it, the Star of David? What are the Star of David stats?
No, that's where the Beyblades have to battle it out. It's in the center of the Star of David.
The Star of David. So like what, you get like, because Jesus was a Jew, right? So I'll get Jesus on my dreidel blade.
Whoa, that's OP as shit.
It's like the Exodia.
Yeah, you know, because he's got the hole in his hands and his feet, and he's got the head. So it kind of forms like a crucified Exodia.
Jesus Christ.
Yeah, playing a lot of Beyblades as a kid growing up, I didn't think about that once.
No, I didn't either.
Never once put those two together.
But it makes so much sense.
It really does.
I think working in marketing has skewed my reality a little bit. So it's just like, I just want to take advantage of
skewed everything. Or has it opened it up?
It's opened it up to new forms of how to take advantage of people. It's like, oh, you your whole life, he's like, don't stereotype people. It's like, that's my job now, is to put you in a little group and sell you shit.
So. But I mean, Beyblade's making a comeback, so you should jump on that.
Is
are they?
Really?
Like, this very slight. Like, it was huge, you know, growing up, and now it's kind of like, there's a nice little section. Like, we're making a comeback. And you're like
some, like sub community of so you got the overall tops like community or whatever, whatever it's fucking called. And then like there's a subgenre for tradles. You know, the people who actually use the strings and shit like that, like, do those crazy, like,
let it rip, yeah.
Yeah, let it rip, and then you got Beyblades.
Like, I wonder if there's, like, a McCoy, what is it, Hatfield-type rivalry against dreidels and Beyblades. Like, I wonder if they, like, get together and they're like, oh, we're beating you this week.
They both bring their own theme songs.
Yeah, something. I don't know.
I'd watch all of them.
Whatever the Beyblade theme song was when that was a cartoon, still.
There's a lot of them. There's too many spin-offs, kind of like Pokemon.
Have you seen how many Yu-Gi-Oh! Spin-offs there are?
Too many.
Jesus Christ. There's like a new character and their hairstyle just gets like 15 times worse every fucking
it's
series.
It's bigger every time.
Bigger and more.
That's how he gets
colorful.
His powers.
More pointy. Yeah. If we've learned anything from anime, more hair means more power.
Yeah, that's definitely true.
What? Not body hair, though. There's never any body hair on any anime characters ever. They're always just
clean. I'm just saying, like, if I'm thinking Super Saiyan.
Yeah.
But I mean,
Gon
like,
from Hunter x Hunter.
That's true.
Mm-hmm. Fuck, I don't know. I'm running out of Orochimaru is pretty strong for a long time.
Until the power creep caught up to him.
Yeah, right.
He was the weakest guy in the universe.
I love when like robots get hair. Like, well, like fucking, I think it was in like Neon Genesis Evangelion. Like the robot just went like fucking berserk, and then he like sprouted some goddamn hair or something. Like,
that just goes to show
but,
that.
But then that's kind of different because they like didn't like the robots become like semi like human or something. I don't really know. That show was so fucked up on. That was like, Jesus Christ, that show was weird.
Jesus Exodia Christ.
Let it rip!
Bring that into church next week?
It's like Norman Reedus having a baby in his stomach.
Speaking of,
oh,
dude,
geez.
The Death Stranding trailer.
I don't
know if you guys have seen it.
I don't know how I feel about it at all.
Oh my god. So they have a third one, and it doesn't have gameplay, I don't think.
No,
maybe
I don't think there's a single bit of gameplay.
But I feel like the gameplay is going to look really similar to the third trailer. But yeah, I don't know if you guys have seen it, but it looks insane. Like, I'm starting to pick up a little bit on what the story is going to be about. And I'm as excited for that as I am the potential new Bloodborne cart.
Sorry.
Just let it rip. We just let coasters rip on the door.
Coaster Beyblades.
I don't think. Mine looks like a waffle, though, so it's not very Jewish.
Shout out to my wife for getting the guy's water.
Now listen to that water pour.
Bar wench,
well,
I would say.
Well done. Soon to be replaced. By a sexual robot.
Doesn't fucking complain. No, maybe I don't need to replace her. Just keep her around. What were we on? Death Stranding.
Yeah.
That trailer was fucking weird, man.
Yeah.
I'm excited for it, though.
That baby was like...
Yeah.
Thumbs up, bitch!
Man, why can't people focus on the actual fucking trailer, though? Because, like, as soon as I saw that the trailer dropped, I saw nothing but babies looking out of, like, throats and shit. I was like, god damn it. Memes are faster and more popular than actual culture now.
I mean, no, seriously, but, like, memes are literally everything. Yeah. People say memes are life. They're not fucking wrong.
People are so concerned that there's not going to be, like, any gameplay at all. I think they thought that it was going to be some kind of, like, play-as-you-go movie kind of thing.
Well, have you ever played a Hideo Kojima game?
Yeah, right.
That's literally a movie.
Right. That's what I thought. And then I was looking up, like, he got fired from that Metal Gear Solid game because he wanted, like, a boss battle to last, like, 2 fucking weeks.
Like, is that the reason why?
Yeah, that's why. Because he wanted to have
he's...
this boss battle that was just epically long, and people were just like, nobody's going to want to play that.
No, because I know that he can. I guess he can be difficult to work with, but like, was it is it Bandai Namco? Is that who? Oh wow, Bandai Namco. Namco Bandai. Isn't that the people he's working with? Oh, it is Konami.
God,
they're so fucking irrelevant now. I can't even remember what their names are. Like, but yeah, Konami. Like,
I feel like I would play a 2 week boss battle. I'm just saying. By the way.
Oh, dude, I would definitely. I mean, as long as it wasn't fucking boring, yeah, I would definitely like try it out.
Can you save in the middle of it?
Well, I would like to hope so. Nobody's...
Yeah, I don't think you're just gonna.
I'd be up for the challenge. Yeah.
What's the longest boss battle you guys have ever actually played?
Ruby though? Weapon, Final Fantasy VII.
Ruby Weapon.
How long
a piece
did it
shit.
Take you to get past Ruby Weapon?
From the first time I tried it to actually beating it.
Well, no, I mean like the length from start to finish inside
of the
battle.
Oh,
the
just one
itself.
Battle.
Oh,
okay.
Yeah.
That's not as fun.
Probably still an hour, hour and a half, two hours.
Oh, man. Final Fantasy 13, I spent like 15 hours on one battle.
Which one?
It was the last one. No, it wasn't actually.
Or
it was that big. It was some big fucking bird? No. God, I can't remember.
I beat Final Fantasy 13. I'm probably the only other person here that has.
I actually really like that like 20 minutes.
I'm trying to keep my negative comments about it.
No, fucking bring him out.
Every
me and him have had a 3-year long argument.
That's
about
pretty much
fucking...
how our friendship has started, is me going hallway simulator and he's like, ah!
He never played it.
13-2.
I played a little bit.
13-2 is, and then 13-3. Oh, fucking trash. Absolute garbage. The third one. Absolute garbage. Ruby Weapon took me like 3 or 4 hours.
Ruby Weapon's a piece of shit. I don't remember how long it took for me to beat it. But like,
I beat Emerald Weapon without the water materia.
Yeah.
That was a pain in the dick.
It was just trying to get the game to like fucking do Knights of the Round every turn. Like eventually it's like, god damn, this is boring. And you just mirror that over and over.
What, no, what is it that, I'm trying to think of what it was that really fucking took me a long time. Like in one battle, I can't really.
Ninja Gaiden used to have a lot.
Those things suck.
You used to have a long ass fight.
If you got a shitty save point before your boss, like you're just fucked.
I mean, I guess more recently, if I'm talking about recent boss battles, Amelia Vicar, or Vicar Amelia from Bloodborne, she took a while for me.
Which
and
is so
like,
weird.
In one fight, that's it.
I feel like people have, like, they either like have really hard times on like one set of bosses or on the other.
Yeah.
And like you had a hard time on the bosses that I breezed through like first tried.
And
then
I
you would go through like the Bloodstarved Beast and you'd be like first or second try. I'm like, yo, what the fuck? I spent like 3 days trying to beat this one fucking boss.
And I remember when I was playing through that and I fucking wiped the floor out of one boss. He was just like, what the hell?
Yeah.
Like, what was Father G? Father G took me like 2 tries.
And
you're like,
that
two...
took me like a day or two of nonstop playing.
But, what is it? But if we're just talking like boss battles in general, I think the longest boss battle it ever took me to beat was that one fucking cannon robot boss thing from Final Fantasy X where you're on the ice.
Oh fuck,
dude, that I don't know what it was, but I was like 12 years old.
Yeah,
I get to that boss. It's like before you get to the temple where you get Shiva.
Yeah.
There's this giant
Final Fantasy X.
Was it Seymour? Was Seymour before or after?
Seymour was after.
Yeah. Okay.
But like there's this giant fucking robot. It's like a mana cannon type deal. And he like it charges up.
Yeah.
That thing took me
On the ice. Okay,
yeah,
okay.
Ice,
yeah.
Yeah. So like I fought that thing so many fucking times. And like it was like impossible to kill, and I put the game down for like months. And then one day I was like, hey, I'll just play it again. And I remembered I was at that boss and I was already kicking myself in the ass for it. Wiped it. One first time I was so pissed off myself.
For the longest time, actually, funny you bring up Final Fantasy X. The first time you fight Seymour, when he's got those two little guys on the side of him.
Yeah,
that,
fuck that.
Yeah.
That was annoying.
Shit.
I couldn't, I had, like, the way I run through games, obviously, you know this. I, like, run through. I don't, like, farm my way up to bosses. Like, I just go, and, like, I'll run away from fights if I have to. Like, even in Dark Souls, Bloodborne, whatever, like, I'll run past shit that I don't have to fight, because I don't want to fucking bother myself with that. I'm just trying to get to the next part, find out the next, because I'm story-driven, like him.
Yeah.
But, yeah, I get to Seymour, and my characters are severely underleveled, and, yeah, and my save point doesn't let me, like, go back at all, if I remember right.
Yeah.
And so, I basically have to just keep going inside trying to, like, it's like a war of contrition. Like, I just have to beat him somehow. All I'm trying to do is kill one of his buddies, because if I kill one of them, I can kill the other one, because there won't be two, like, Kiragas going on.
Yeah.
And then I can kill Seymour finally. Never fucking happened. So I dropped the game. I didn't beat it. And then I picked it up, 2 years ago, and replayed all the way through it, get to that part, one hit the one dude, had to two hit the other guy, and then I wiped Seymour. I don't know. It's just weird. I think it might be something crazy when we're little kids.
I remember playing that thoroughly. My dad played it thoroughly. My brother wanted to get into it. My brother got into it late. And he put an ungodly amount of effort into the Blitzball. Like,
That's how you get Waka's ultimate weapon, though.
Yeah. Max leveled, like, his whole fucking team. And he's like, I'm like, why do you have 400 hours played in this? You're like halfway through the story, he's like, Blitzball. Like,
I fucking hate winning that first tournament.
Everyone
and then they still play it like you fucking lost.
Yeah.
That's the biggest bullshit.
Everyone wanted a Blitzball game like standalone. Cause like how fucking fun, like even now I would still play Blitzball.
And just update the system so it's a bit more like not as clunky. Like I would totally take EA Blitzball.
Hell yeah. I'm sorry, but doing the Jack shot didn't mean shit. It was all about the poison shot.
Was it Jack shot 2? Is that a thing too?
I don't remember. I just remember using the poison shot would like suck out their endurance.
Oh my god, motherfucker.
Oh hell yeah. And then that was how you got the score and shit.
I never really played. I'm not a completionist by any means. I think the only like in-game minigame I've ever spent time on was Final Fantasy IX's card game.
That was a really fun card game, though, to be fair. Game.
Yeah. And you could do it as the game progressed.
Mm-hmm.
It wasn't just like Blitzball where it was as one time thing where you had to, you know.
Blitzball was ongoing.
Well.
You could go back to it.
Right, but you had to go seek it out.
Right, yeah,
you had to go back to the place to
actively recruit your team.
Mm-hmm.
That's cool. Yeah.
I feel like all the Final Fantasies up to maybe 11 or 12 had like really good mini games involved in them. Because like even 8 had a good card game too, I thought. It was really clunky, but it was still fun.
Yeah. 9 pretty much just improved on
it. Yeah. But 13, I don't know. I like 13 a lot. I didn't really play the 13. Two or the last 13 or anything, and then I played 15 and I didn't even beat 15 because as much as I love Final Fantasy, I couldn't force myself to play that any longer. I don't think
that game.
Huh?
I love 15. It's awesome.
Loved it.
Loving every minute of it.
I don't know. I just got to a point where I was like, I can't do this anymore.
You just hate yourself.
I don't know. It just. The whole hack and slash thing, like, it felt more like a Devil May Cry game with the Final Fantasy story.
Which game were we talking about?
Final Fantasy 15.
Oh, okay, yeah, switched to that. Yeah, Final Fantasy 15 was not fun for me.
I haven't touched any since, like, 10-2 and maybe, like, 3 hours of 11, which was kind of different.
That's the thing, like, Final Fantasy 15 really fucking made me upset, though. Because, like, graphics are great. The story from what I played was pretty solid. I enjoyed literally just that open world environment, you know, being able to run around and, you know, with your boys and shit, but like, man, that gameplay is straight ass.
I just missed the like chess aspect of it, because people used to have a big complaint about turn-based, and like, that was always my favorite part of it, was like, you can't just slash your way through every fight, like, you actually have to plan your shit out, you know, like, you both got health bars, you have to plan your attacks and shit, like, if he pulls out one of his bigger attacks and you're trying to be ballsy and like, attack instead of healing up or something, you die.
Yeah.
But, like, otherwise you're playing Dark Souls, you know, and you're just trying to dodge roll or whatever, parry, whatever, and, like, that's not Final Fantasy at all,
no.
You know? Like, they started on turn-based. If you go all the way back to 1 with the Red Mage, Black Mage, all that shit, still turn-based. Then you go all the way to, like, 13, and it's, like, there's an ATB gauge system, but it's still turn-based, technically. And then 15 hits, and it's, nope, it's all hack and slash now.
Yep. Straight ass.
No.
Better straight away, then.
So now
you always fall back on sex dolls.
Yeah. So I always fall back on sex dolls.
Like,
what about sex competitions between sex dolls?
Or just people in general?
Sex
competitions.
How long can I pelvic thrust into this fucking slut?
It's an endurance test.
I'm a banana ram.
As long as you have a fan, I'm ready to go.
He doesn't compete in tournaments that don't allow customized robots because he has very specific needs.
Imagine like a liquid cooling system.
The tagline for our sex robot line could be "Let it rip."
God, just, like, <what? laughs>
that brilliant mark.
What are we ripping?
That's up to you.
You do it.
Skiff's asshole again.
Get more anal fissures. That'd be fantastic.
I mean, if you say so.
Jeez.
Oh, fuck. Well,
We probably should have prepared something.
Yeah, no, we just
an impromptu throw together last minute.
We'll probably just call it there. It was a pretty decent run, I think. So,
40 minutes.
Yeah.
That's an appropriate amount of time.
Yeah, that's pretty decent.
With commercial, we'll hit an hour, yeah.
Yeah.
Just sort of like try to get that YouTube money. Just kind of, hey, advertise halfway through, please. Please, I need the content. So anyway, no, that's where we're going to wrap it up. Again, Local Boys Codcast. Codcast. Yo, the really great idea.
Try it canned. It's better canned.
A fishing podcast called the Codcast.
That'll be tomorrow.
We can just talk about
Bando Namkai.
We'll just talk about sex.
The Bando Namkai Codcast.
We'll talk about sex dolls while fly fishing.
You just hold the whole sex doll with a fucking, like,
string attached to its tooth or something like that.
Oh my god.
I was thinking like straight out of the head, like.
No, you use a guy. So like when you're reeling it in, you just grab the dick and you crank it to rope the real string in, right?
Or the Dominatrix edition, because she comes with a complimentary whip.
Okay, well, we extended the life of the podcast for 2 seconds.
Yeah.
We're gonna wrap it up there. So, the Loafer Boys podcast, thanks for listening. I'm Skiff.
I'm Zach.
Comanche.
Tyler.
And, bye.